is David Stark from WatcherPass.com, your website for movie reviews, interviews, and recommendations. Today, I'm joined by the stars of The Paper Tigers, Alain Uy, Ron Yuan, and Mykel Shannon Jenkins, which releases in theaters and digitally on May 7th, 2021. We're going to talk to them in just a second, but first, let's check out the trailer. And while you're watching, if you can like and subscribe to this channel, that would be fantastic.
What's popping?
Hey, what's going on?
Oh, you know, everything. Just promoting this movie.
This is fantastic.
Maybe you heard of it.
I saw it. It was pretty awesome, and now I get to talk to y'all. So this is pretty fantastic.
Thank you
so much for joining me. I guess, you know, so the film is The Paper Tigers. It's about three, you know, kind of old kung fu masters, I guess, who are now kind of dealing with life. So I guess the first question is, how did you, you know, you're all like fun, energetic movie stars. So how did you get into the mind of like an old, boring person? Did you just, you know, next time you can just spend like a month with me and you'll get perfectly set up for it. So
gain 68 pounds and don't sleep.
That's just quarantine. That's just how it is. But I guess, how y'all feeling today? You feeling good? Any aches, any pains we should know about before we start this?
No, feeling good. Awesome. Feeling good.
So I think the best thing to do right now would be I want to see who is like the supreme master of this group. So I think you just all fight and we'll determine a winner, and then we can, you know.
Well,
I don't know where I'm positioned, but I'm just punching everybody.
You're just beating everyone up. All right, so Elaine is definitely the lead disciple. So I guess this film was so different. Like, I guess it spoke to me because I'm starting to get to the point in my life where The Paper Tigers were. You know, you're starting to kind of deal with the real life situations and, you know, kind of losing that exuberance of youth. But what drew you all to this film? It's such a kind of unique script, especially for a martial arts movie. You don't normally have this kind of a setup. So what drew you all to this film? And, you know, we can, whoever wants to start can go. I can call on people if that's easier. I guess we'll start with you, Ron. You're above me in my screen. So,
Yuji Okumoto, the producer, one of the producers, great producing team, and he sent me the script. We've been friends for over 20 years. He knew, actually, because we talk a lot, that I actually wanted to get back into comedy, because back in the day I did stand up and different stuff. So he's like, hey man, I think I got the script. I think you're gonna dig it. It's kind of old school, it's kind of this, but you know what? I don't want to tell you anything. I just want you to read it. So I was like, okay, cool. I read it. As I was reading it, page turner. I'm like, oh my God, this is like, you know, just everything, how we grew up and the fact that Jim was black. And for me personally, you know, also Elaine too, like we both were, you know, very, very just ingratiated. Like for me, you know, black culture was amazing for me because, you know, growing up, you know, with bouts of racism and stuff, it was the black community that embraced me. And you know, for me, just so when I was reading it, and the fact that I'm older now and not being able to do the things that you used to, you know, I was just like, this stuff cracks me up. But what really bonded me to the script was the relationship between the three brothers. Yeah. And I just thought it was beautiful.
Elaine, you want to go next?
Yeah, I for me, what really drew me to the story, the script and the movie was the story. I mean, it is, you know, I am in that period of my life where, very much like you, where you're trying to figure out what your priorities are and kind of wrestling with the idea, in many ways mourning the 20 year old version of you, where you still feel that person, but you know, life gets in the way and things change. So I think for me, the characters themselves, in terms of, you know, where they are and where we see them and where we meet them in present time, and it really drew me immediately. It has a ton of heart, the film, and obviously like the requisite action that's involved, but really seeing what those characters experience in those moments of action or drama or comedy and dealing with themselves, I think it's a story that I think we could all relate to as we age.
Yeah.
Maybe just as an African American, I look at age differently. you know, black don't crack.
I have a son. Asian don't raisin.
I have a son, and I remember watching him. What I loved about what drew me to Jim was, first of all, the opportunity to put forth a true. I've often felt like, you know, I may not live the rest of my life with my wife, but my dog's gonna ride with me until I roll up out of here. Mm-hmm. So that kind of love isn't like really put out in the depth and the way that we care. There's a man cave in everybody's house for a reason. Like, we just bond like that. And so, like, my son, when he was young, I used to just dominate him in basketball, just dominate him. And now he's a little at the age where he can beat me, so I just don't play anymore. But I'm constantly trying to tell him the quicker ways, like Jim, the best way to finish the shit fast, which he will have no part of. You know what I mean? Like, you can't. So it's the frustration of like having all this information and like you can't kind of do it the way you used to. So you're trying to give it to somebody who has all this talent, but they can't. It's very real to me. And how that leaves you back to your group to talk about the times when you guys were the shit and when it was fresh. And like, for some people, that is their best part of their life ever. And when you have two people who were there with you when you were like the best part of your life ever, and then you get a chance to meet again in life and then live another good part of your life, was an opportunity I just couldn't walk away from. Like, it just felt right.
Yeah, and I think you just described the perpetual cycle of like, you now have the experience, you're trying to pass it on, but the youth don't want to hear it. You know, they're invincible, they know everything already, so they don't need it. And it's just this constant cycle. But, you know, I did love that aspect of this film where you've got these, you know, these masters that, you know, they can't do what they used to do, but they still have the knowledge. Like, Ron, your character with his, you know, his hearing of just kind of like knowing what the right technique was really interesting to watch. And I did kind of love the how no one gave you respect until eventually you got it. Or not. See the movie. See what happens. But you all are clearly, you know, imagine filming this film, you became really good friends just because of the characters and how much fun it was. You're clearly friends now. How did you kind of get that camaraderie for the screen? Did you know each other beforehand? Had you crossed in any similar circles, or did you just kind of, you know, hit the ground running?
I think it was Bao who really created an environment for us to really connect in an organic way. I think there was a lot of improvisation that was happening when we were rehearsing this stuff, the script, and it really, again, it put us in a situation where we created those organic you know, connections. And I think there's a lot of similarities. There's a lot of things that we enjoy outside of film and acting that we all kind of went, oh, you're into that, I'm into that, and it all happened rather quickly. It was in that rehearsal period that we were just like, man, this is going to be a lot of fun. And you know, to a man here, in terms of just being in productions where sometimes you don't connect with the other actors, this was one of those moments where you're like, oh, this is going to be a lot of fun. Because I knew Ron, we did a video game together, but I didn't know who Mykel was. In fact, I didn't know anybody else on set. But it was one of those things, first day of school, you go in, and no one really clicked up. It was just like, let's just all sit in the same lunch table and just have fun. And it was great. It was instantaneous in that regard.
I'm gonna sit down for 10 seconds. You can see a girl, and in the first moment you meet her, you know, that's my wife. It's like, it took about 30 seconds, but I'm like, oh yeah, these dudes, man. No, for real, like that feeling was like right there. And then we fed it. Like, we breakfast, lunch, and dinner, we were just together. And we didn't want to not be together. Like, we ride in the car there, ride in the same back from set, wait for people to finish. Like, nobody had to tell nobody to wait. We just didn't want to do it unless you were with it. You know what I mean? So, like, it happens when you let it happen and when you have the right people. Just lucky, very blessed, humbled by the whole thing, really.
So, Mykel, you're saying 30 seconds you knew that you want me to be your wife?
Well, I think it's wives. I think your brother wives. If that's
allowed. Next week. All right.
I think I'm out of time, but I got one last question. Okay. You know, this is a martial arts film. I imagine you all were sparring a little bit to prep and whatnot. So you must know who would win in a fight between you three. I just need to know the correct answer.
Ron.
No, me. I would just charm everybody and just crack jokes and make people dance. And we wouldn't even fight. It wouldn't even be a fight. You would just be like, hey, Ron, let's go get some.
Man,
it's be over.
That's what, jump kick it? 70 pounds heavy? I was like, yeah, I'm on no part of that.
I don't know. Mikhail's answer makes me think he plays a little dirty, so maybe he would bring that into the.
I'm dirty as they come, but he throwing me bricks on himself. I'm like, what? You know what? He like a miniature Bruce Lee. He got like 19 different styles. I'm like, this dude.
No, I'm not even. I was kidding. Ron would kick. He would
still. I would bring friends. I'd bring friends. That's all I'm gonna say.
Mikhail and Elaine are incredible athletes, and you know, they were wonderful to work with. I would never fight them. I wouldn't want to fight them. I love them, but they were awesome. I love enjoying just working with them and watching them work. It was beautiful.
Spoken like a true politician.
True master right there.
So now you know who the real master is.
There you go. All right. Well, thank you so much for your time. The movie is The Paper Tigers, and it has action, it has humor, it has heart, it kind of has everything, and you know, it's got something for everyone. So thank you so much for your time, and thanks for talking to me.
Thank you. Thanks for your time.
That was Alain Uy, Ron Yuan, and Mykel Shannon Jenkins, the stars of The Paper Tigers, which releases digitally and in theaters on May 7th, 2021. It's a very funny movie, and it deals with a lot topic that I think a lot of us are dealing with right now as we age, so you should definitely check it out. If you liked this interview, please like and subscribe to this channel. It helps me out a lot to make sure all my new interviews go straight to you. And as always, please go to WatcherPass.com for all your movie reviews, interviews, and recommendations. Thank you.